So, I know I said in the last video that it would be the last in the series, and I apologize for that. I forgot that I was splitting these up into two videos, and after that last one went on for so long, I figured I should stick to my formula. So, welcome to the last Wario Land Let's Play video, assuming Syrup Castle was the last level, which I'm pretty sure it is at this point. Because, I mean, if there's two more areas in Syrup Castle, then the next one will be number 40, which is a nice round number to end a game on. You know, that's a back-of-the-box quote. 40 levels! Now, it would be better if there were 41 levels, because then they could say, over 40 levels! Because, you know, when you're a kid, and you're looking at the back of a video game box, there are pretty much exactly two things you care about. One, how many levels. And two, can you jump on things? Those are the two criteria when you're a kid. How many things are there to jump on? How many levels can you jump on things in? Now, I was kind of a dumb kid, and I had some pretty sketchy criteria, back-of-the-box criteria, that I didn't get over until later in life. Like, I spent too long caring about licensed characters in video games, and that ended up with me playing some pretty weird stuff. Krusty's Super Fun House on the Sega Genesis is one notable example, since obviously I was a big Simpsons fan. And, you know, this is like Lemmings, except there's Krusty the Clown from The Simpsons. I love The Simpsons. Except, oh, it's not actually as good as Lemmings. And it doesn't really have anything to do with The Simpsons. I still think Krusty's Funhouse was a pretty good game. It wasn't great or anything. The music is horrible. So yeah, if you want to play Krusty's Funhouse, do yourself a favor and crank that music right on down to zero. Play some hot jams on your portable stereo cassette player instead, because you know it's 1993 and everything, and I'm playing Krusty's Super Funhouse. I don't think I had a stereo at that point, though. I wouldn't get one until, I think I did. Well, no, because Krusty's Funhouse was one of the first Genesis games I got. And I remember playing Lost Vikings a lot while I listened to Metallica. My uncle had Lost Vikings, and I borrowed the game from him. And, I was just getting into metal at that point, and specifically the album Injustice for All, which I, of course, dubbed onto cassette tape from one of my friend's CDs. So yeah, those two games kind of go hand in hand in my memory banks, but I believe when I played Krusty's Funhouse, that was pre-stereo. So yeah, I had to contend with that horrible music. But, you know, I was like 9 years old at the time or something like that, so obviously I had no taste. Oh, no secrets over here, I guess. So, well, that's kind of neat. I like those springy blocks. Those feel pretty good. Thanks. Man, if I died before I activated that checkpoint, I would be a little peeved. But speaking of licensed characters, probably my most embarrassing video game memory is the time, for whatever reason, my parents let me rent a video game for the weekend, and the game I chose for the Sega Genesis was Chester Cheetah's Wild Wild Quest. not only a video game licensed after a Cheese Puff mascot, but it wasn't even the good video game licensed on a Cheese Puff mascot. It was like the third one. Well, the second or the third one. And it was embarrassingly bad. That was probably my biggest regret until high school. The fact that the one weekend I could get an extra game to play for a couple days, the one I chose was Chester Cheetah's Wild Wild Quest. Man, I don't know what I was thinking. But you know, I played that game for hours and hours because that was what I had. Huh. Well, that was kind of a fun little romp. Man, I do not feel confident about the structural integrity of this castle. Alright, is this the last level? Looks like it. See, normally there's like a little skull there to show you that that's where the boss is, but in this one, the whole thing is a skull. So, course number 40. Let's see if this game has 40 levels or over 40 levels. Nah, I'm not going for that last coin. Pushing my luck as it is. This music's good. This is the scary music I was expecting. Nice. Okay. Interesting. I don't know how I get these. Well, that sure isn't how. I had to try though. Video games are all about experimentation. Man, I should go back and play Chester Cheetah's Wild Wild Quest just to see how badly I scarred myself. I mean, I don't remember anything about it, because obviously I would have repressed that memory. But you know, there's something about going back and experiencing something you only experienced once, 20 years ago, that really makes your brain feel funny. Like, I've been going back and watching some of the later Ren and Stimpy episodes, like not season 1 and 2, because I've seen all those a billion times, but like there are episodes in season 4 and 5 of Ren and Stimpy that I've only seen like once, 20 years ago, and going back to those now just makes my brain do flip-flops. Because it's like somewhere deep, deep down in the dark recesses of my memory, those episodes are there. And then watching them again just brings it all back. I have a feeling playing Wild Wild Quest would be a similar feeling. That was close. Man, these hidden heart blocks are all over the place. Alright, so what did I do to die here, and how can I prevent that from happening again? I think I just missed one of these bouncy spring things. Maybe I was trying too hard to get coins or something. Checkpoint. Maybe, maybe not. Yep, there it is. Nice. The checkpoints actually kind of remind me of the checkpoints in Shovel Knight. Like, they're not destructible like the ones in Shovel Knight, and they're not like a globe, but like the shape of them is kind of similar. I guess it is kind of a globe. It's like a coin globe. And it's being very generous with the coins in this level. I believe someone mentioned something about later in the game that the coins become way more plentiful. And this might be what they were talking about. And it's giving me a lot of power-ups, too. There must be something big coming. You jerk. Well, now what am I supposed to do? Do I have to get that knife thing to hit this door? To open it? Is that why he's there? Come on, you big galoof. Galoof? I mean galoot. I sort of did a portmanteau of goof and galoot. I guess the reason I'm not racking up the coins is just because I'm dying all the time. Because otherwise, I mean, if I wasn't dying all the time, I would probably be exiting these levels with like 50-ish to 100 coins every time. And my coin supply would be a little better than it is now. But it's okay. The coins are made up and the points don't matter. Man, it just sounds like a coin bonanza up there. Like there's a slot machine up there that's just doling them out. Alright, let's try not to get hurt this time. I mean, I really had no reason to try to kill that knight. I was just being vindictive. Alright, so I don't have to... Well, I guess my theory about trying to get the knight to hit the door seems like it would make sense. I just have to, provoke him, I guess. Now, how do I do that? Do I have to hit him to provoke him? I guess so. Okay, so what do? I guess I need to hit him when he's walking to the left. So that way when he gets back up, he'll charge to the right. And hopefully he'll charge the whole distance. Oops. Well, that might work. Nope. Well, he charged the door and didn't do anything. Do I have to kill the knight? Because if that's the case, I'm in trouble. Oh, I see. I just had to hit him in the back a certain number of times, I guess. Interesting. You know, could have communicated that a little bit more clearly. Like maybe, why do I keep falling off? I'm holding onto the dang ladder. Like maybe if the door had like three little stars on it or something, and every time you hit the knight, one of the stars disappeared, or something like that. Of course, you know, I'm no Nintendo employee. Man, that is bad visual communication. It looks like I should still be holding onto those ladders. And now I have to do the whole night sequence again. Great. Man, ladders in this game seem to be my worst enemy. Like, I didn't want to go too high on the ladders because I didn't want to be hit by the fireballs. But if you go, like, just a hair lower than you think you should, you just fall off the ladder. A bit frustrating. Do you like the physics on those sun blocks, though. That felt pretty good. Alright, Nightman. See, it has like three, I guess, mandibles on the skull or something. But, but it didn't utilize them. Also, I don't think you should bounce off that door. And see, I don't see any reason that thing should be bouncy. So yeah, this game has a lot of little quirks. Oh well, at least I get to do the sunblocks again. I just really love the velocity you get on these things. Like, normally, Wario is so slow. Like, he just lumbers like an elephant. But on these blocks, he has a good amount of speed. I guess it's similar to what you get from the jetpack. The same general kind of feeling. I think I forgot to get that last time. Weird background design in this level too. Like, those, I guess those are windows, but the way they have like a bow on top of them, they look kind of like a present. Which is a little weird. It's like a deadly present. I thought he would keep charging. But, man, I should have saved one of those garlics. I was too greedy for those hearts. Okay, ladders, don't screw me over. Come on. Like, you have to be way higher on the ladders than you think you should. Even higher than that? Jesus. Like, you cannot waste any time. Alright, Mulman. I don't like you, and you don't like me. But you and me, we're in this together. Well, until I killed you. I guess after that, we weren't in it together. He turned around on me. But you know, it happens. Yeah, that looks... yeah, there is a globe. There's a globe with, like, a light inside, just like the checkpoint in Shovel Knight. I wonder if that was a direct inspiration. Because, you know, there's a lot about that game. Obviously, that's inspired by older games. You know, a lot of Zelda 2 influence, a lot of Mega Man influence. It's quite possible that those checkpoints were directly inspired by the checkpoints in this game, which is pretty cool. I feel kind of silly getting those coins again every single time. When, you know, my total coin amount is not increasing. You know, I always have 60-ish coins by the time I get here. Yeah, you can't really jump over this guy either. You kind of have to be near one of these blocks if you want to get past him. Alright, ladders. I've had just about enough of your shenanigans. Weird sound effect on these fireballs, too. Oh crap. Okay, moles. You win this round. But next time, I won't get hit by you. I promise. You can take that to the bank. The riverbank, because you're a mole. And you probably like to hang out there. Oh. This is a thing. Okay. So I guess I have to put him back in the lamp or something. Hmm. Oh, I see. I guess it creates platforms for me to stand on. Hmm. Well, that was fast. I have no idea who that guy is, or who that girl was. They're both complete strangers to me. Apparently, it has something to do with that duck that Wario messes with at the very beginning of the game, before you start playing, like the cutscene. Someone said that the story actually has something to do with that. I don't know. Is this genie guy one of the pirates? Is he allied with the pirates? I guess I have to defeat the genie and find out. These mysteries will be explained, hopefully. Alright, I'm just gonna leave those garlics until after I deal with the knight, just in case. Alright. Figured you out, Knight. I've got your number. 8675309. That's your number. Everyone should go call that right now and leave a nasty message. Be like, Duke owned you, you stupid knight, and hang up. I'm sure whoever owns that number would really appreciate it. I mean, that knight would appreciate it because he owns that number. That's his number. I don't like my current power-up status, but it seems like I always get hit around here anyway, so I guess I should be okay. As long as I don't get hit again, of course. Alright, so, looks like I have to throw the lamp, jump on the little smoke platforms it creates, and then jump and hit him on the head. And these fireballs he throws are really fast, so I have to be quick on the draw for that one. Or maybe... I don't know. Let's try throwing it at his head. Okay, so it only creates a platform when it lands. Okay, so that is in fact a platform. Alright. My theory was fruitful. Man, this guy's giving me the finger. I don't appreciate that, genie. Uh-oh. Is there a way I can force this thing to land right side up? I don't seem to have any control over it. Is it just a roll of the dice? Oh. Oh, I did not mean to lose 10 coins for no reason. Ah, okay, so when I jumped, it landed right side up, so maybe I just have to jump and throw it. Well, didn't do it that time. I don't think there's anything special I have to do. Crap! I got too fixated on the platform. Alright, well, I'm getting closer. I had the pattern down pretty well there for a while. Until I got obsessed with getting the hit in. I mean, I was a little worried because my time was getting pretty low. And I don't want to take forever on that boss and end up running out of time. But this time I think I should have him. Assuming there's not like a second and third form and stuff. Which is quite possible. You don't see it very often in Mario and Mario related games. Having a second form for the boss. Yoshi's Island does that. It has a second form. Although the first form is so easy that it practically doesn't count. Trying to think of other Mario games that have it. I mean, I'm sure a lot of the newer Mario games have more involved, complicated bosses, but I haven't played a ton of those. Of course, it's kind of a fallacy to think about this game in terms of Mario games anyway, because it really has so little in common with anything else in the Mario universe. Alright, I want to leave those garlics there just in case. Because if I get hit, I'd like to go into the boss with horns if possible. Instead of just being big. And assuming I don't get hit, looks like that should be doable. Alright, I just have to be careful around these blades, not rush through this area. Crap, I feel a sneeze coming on. Oh, it died. Hate it when that happens. Alright, genie. Time to put you back in that lamp. Is that Mighty Bomb Jack on the lamp? Or maybe it's that alien creature. I remember in the first Mario Land game, I kind of thought that alien creature looked like Mighty Bomb Jack. Saw it coming. Oh yeah, that's right, having horns doesn't give you an extra hit anyway. Well, screw it. Really wish this was more intuitive than just keep throwing it and hope for the best. Oh man, I have to kill those guys or they don't go away. That sucks. Hope this guy doesn't have that many hits. I keep having some very close calls. See, that's pointing Spoutside up. That should be enough to release a cloud. Sorry, pause to take a drink of water there. Alright, course number 40. You're just a video game. I've conquered harder video games than you in the past, and I know I can conquer this one. If I just persevere, put my mind to it. Wish I had some montage training music. Because I kind of feel like that's what I'm doing now. This is all training for the final event. Alright, still going to leave that there. Just in case. I mean, I don't need to leave all these garlics here, but there's really no reason to pick them up either. I mean, they give you like 10 hearts or something if you get the garlic when you already have the bullhorns. But it shouldn't take me 14 more lives to beat this boss, hopefully. I'm crossing my fingers. Alright, gotta watch out for the mole. You ain't the boss of Meemole. And you're not so big. Aw, man. I was hoping those blades would kill the mole. I guess it doesn't work like that. Just gotta be patient. Oh, did he lose his Morning Star? I mean, it really doesn't matter because, like I found out, the bullhorns don't give you an extra hit point anyway. So screw it. Wario should just run up and grab the lamp. I mean, he knows something like this is going to happen. At least he should. So is that like... is that Pauline? Or, no. Pauline is a different... she's the Donkey Kong princess. And then Daisy is the Mario Land princess. And then Peach is the Mario Brothers princess. But I don't think that's, I don't think that's Daisy. Oh, hey! I can get a bounce off those guys and get high enough to hit them. For some reason, it didn't look like I could bounce high enough off of the mini genies. And I'm sure that there's some trick to this that I'm just not getting, and people are screaming at their computer screens right now. Duke, you have to hold up while you throw the lamp. I tried that. That didn't do anything. You have to hit down, back, forward, B to throw the lamp. And it lands the right way up every time. You have to throw it when the last digit of the timer is a multiple of 3. And it lands right side up every time. Actually, wouldn't surprise me if it was something like that. This game has done weirder stuff than that in the past. I mean, they've done the whole multiples of a number thing before. I mean, that controls how many fireworks you get in Super Mario Brothers. The last digit of the timer has to be... I don't think it's a multiple of anything, but it's like, there's certain numbers. But, I mean, all that is it's like an extra flourish and a point bonus. And I'm glad that didn't hurt me. It looked like I hit the spiky part. I have to say, still not as bad as Wario's Castle in Mario Land 2. I mean, yeah, the boss is tough, but you know, the last boss is kind of supposed to be tough. And let's face it, the last boss of Mario Land 2, it's kind of a pushover. I mean, I don't think I died against him, but you know, obviously. That was very, very relieving at the time, because I was so frustrated with that level. Alright, I'm just gonna keep picking it up and throwing it. I honestly don't know what else to do. Well, it's not multiples of 3, because the timer was a 6. Maybe it's multiples of 2? Doesn't seem to be that. Maybe it just has to be. Okay, so it was a 4 that time. Let me try doing it. Well, let me pay attention to the mini genie, because I can actually use him to get a hit. Alright, so let's try throwing it when it's a 4 and see if it lands right side up. Nope, it's not that. I mean, that's just a wild theory, but, actually, it was a 4. Oh, you can get multiple hits on him like that, too. It was a 4 when it stopped rolling, not when I threw it. So I probably mucked that up. But then the second time, it was a 6. So I don't think that has any significance. See, it was a 4 that time, 3 that time, nothing. Nope. See, that time I didn't even get a bounce off this guy. This is a tough boss. If you're getting impatient, you might want to just skip forward a little bit. I'll put an annotation in that you can click on that takes you right to when I defeat him. If you want to skip my next few deaths, because honestly, it's probably not going to get much more entertaining at this point. Don't really have anything else to say. Just want to get in, get the genie, and get out. It's Operation Genie Kill. Operation I Scream at Genie. I can think of a better joke than that. Operation... I'm trying to think of like Genie from Aladdin related jokes. I can't think of any. I guess Ice Cream at Genie is about as good as it gets. I haven't seen Aladdin in a really long time, so I don't really have any specific Aladdin Genie references to pull out. And that mole is really difficult to hit, unless you hit him exactly from the back. Like, I wouldn't recommend trying to jump on him, like, at any stage. Just wait until he's facing away from you and just walk into him. Man, I hope Wario Land 2 controls better than this game, and the other Wario Land games. I mean, I hear they get better. But, you know, people also seem to have a lot of reverence for this game, so... Like, I don't know if it's just a nostalgia thing or what. I mean, once again, not knocking the game. It's cool, but it's not great. Man, now that I know I can hit him multiple times off that, it's gonna make my job easier. His finger waggle thing reminds me of Phantasy Star 3 on the Genesis. There's an enemy that attacks you by just waggling its finger at you. It's pretty amusing. I think it's his index finger, not his middle finger. It's still pretty funny. Alright, I need to wait until I deal with Mini Genie before I throw it again. No, come back here, you jerk. Nope, that was a bad throw. I'm not going to be able to hit him from here. What was I thinking? It really looks like the mini genie is pooping out those fireballs. I mean, sorry to be crass, but I feel like I have to insult this guy any way I can. You know, get my hits in where they're available. Because obviously, I can't actually beat this boss. When it flashes like that, does that mean I'm bad? Is it saying, wow, you really suck at this, you've done this level like a billion times? Or does it always flash? I don't know. Seems like it only flashes some of the time. I should just ignore all this stuff, really. There's no reason for me to to spend a ton of time trying to get all these coins. I wonder, yeah, I can skip one. Because, I mean, it's not like after I beat the genie, I'm going to be like, oh, dang, I don't have enough coins to do the bonus game. I'm sure torn up about that. I'm not just relieved that I finally finished the game. Glad I figured this guy out, though. And I wish that was the boss. That'd be a satisfying win, wouldn't it? Yeah, I hit this guy 3 times. This random knight character. Who's... just some schmuck. Game over. Alright, be patient, Duke. Although I don't know why I'm worried, because there's another power-up over here anyway. I like how she just whacks the lamp. Like, that's as good of an animation as they could do for rubbing the lamp. Just pound that sucker. Man, I'm gonna start throwing it against the wall. I can get way more throws. Get way more throws out of it that way. Of course, none of these are coming up the right direction, so maybe it's not such a hot idea. Maybe it's positional? Maybe, like, relative to the genie. If it's in a certain location, maybe it's more likely to land right side up. I don't know. Whew. Okay, so I can just kind of jump into those guys, as long as I don't get hit by the fireball. I mean, it just seems really shitty that the final boss would be this total luck-based thing. Yes, got 3 hits that time. I'm the best. Uh-oh. Oh, thank God. It gave me like 100 coins for that. That's pretty cool. Alright, so she's mad at me. But I rescued her. And she threw a bomb at me. Oh. Okay. So I guess she is the princess? Oh hey, it's Mario. Was not expecting to see him. Is that a statue of Peach? He's like, oh well. Well, at least I got the lamp. It's gotta be worth something, right? Well, at least he's happy now. I love that dialogue noise. That is the best. Alright, so what do I want to wish for? Castle? Wouldn't you rather have money? That's a pretty good bit of coins. Alright, so I guess I get to see what my final score is now. And I guess that changes the ending somehow? From what I've heard. Alright, so the dagger... Holy crap! Dagger is worth 7,000? Good God. 8,000? Oh, this is quite the development. And the crappy glove is only worth 4,000. Yeah, the sports equipment naturally would be worth practically nothing. That shield's probably worth a lot. Yeah, 7,000. I wonder if it's tiered, like all the top tier stuff is worth, or like A through E is all worth 7,000. The middle stuff is all worth 5,000. Well, no, because one of them was 8,000. Hmm. Alright, final score, 37,708. Well, I got a gold bag out of it. Two gold bags. I guess that's pretty good. Oh, so I have to pay the genie before he'll grant my wish. Okay. That's what he wasn't saying, do I want money? He was saying, give me some money. Man. That dialogue noise, it makes it all worth it. Hmm. Well, that wasn't exactly the castle that I envisioned. Aw, Wario's sad. He's like, I don't want to live in a tree. Alright. Whoa. Text is all screwy. Well, this has been Let's Play Wario Land. It's been a wild ride. There's been a lot of ups and downs, a lot of laughs, a lot of crying. Mostly crying in the last couple levels, to be honest, but I made it through it. Yeah, can't say I like this game a whole lot. It's, I mean, it's fine, you know, and I don't regret playing it or anything, but, it just does not feel, definitely does not feel as good as playing a Mario game. You know, I hate to be negative, but not my favorite thing in the world. I'm hoping that the next games are better, because like as far as aesthetic goes, I really love this game and Mario Land 2. I think Mario Land 2 is a better game. Of the three games I played so far in the Mario Land series, Mario Land 2 is the best. And I'd say this is still better than Mario Land 1, just because there's so much more to it. And like, I really love how everything looks. I like the attitude that the game has. Like, it's really weird. I can appreciate that. I do like weird stuff a whole lot. But this game, like I said, it's just not that sticky for me. But I will continue my Wario Land quest with Let's Play Wario Land 2. I think, was that also a Game Boy game, or was that Game Boy Color by that point? I know there are four, and Wario Land 4 is Game Boy Advance. Maybe, I think Wario Land 2 is still Game Boy, and then Wario Land 3 might be Game Boy Color, and then 4 is GBA, I think. I could be wrong. But yeah, I do plan on going through the whole series eventually. Thanks, David Patton. Thanks, Graham Archer. That sounds like a made-up name. Graham Archer. Testing player, what, just the one? Oh, never mind. Takashita Masafumi? Yep. Oh, Fukui Kota. That's, it's a classic. Really glad that Game Credit started using the actual Japanese names, not the weird pseudonyms that they used in, like, the late 80s and early 90s. Like, it'll say director, and then in quotations it'll have like Sammy Boy, you know, that's an obvious pseudonym, instead of Shigeru Miyamoto or whoever. I mean, that's not a real example, that's just something that that happened a lot. I had to say pretty disappointed with the size of my castle. I wonder if this is the worst one or if there's something below tree. I mean, it's not even a whole tree. It's just like a dead tree trunk that's been turned into a house. Not really sure what would be below that. Maybe a rock or something. Maybe if you finish with 0 coins, he just lives underneath a rock, like Patrick from SpongeBob SquarePants. A rock just comes out and crushes him. Enjoy your new house, loser. Hope you like living under a rock. Actually, I wonder if there is anything for 0 coins. Can you imagine how difficult it would be to finish? Well, I guess it's impossible to finish with 0 coins. Because, please retry. I don't think so. Sorry. But yeah, you can't finish with 0 coins because there are bosses that automatically give you coins and stuff. But it would be an interesting thing to watch. Like a low percent run. Like finish the game with as few coins as possible. So yeah, that'll do it for Let's Play Wario Land. If you want to watch someone who's really good at this game and knows a lot about it, I recommend going to CPC Gamer's channel and following his Wario Land LP. And stay tuned to my channel for something. Probably Super House of Dead Ninjas will be the next thing I do. So yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. As always, you know, follow me on the stuff. I'm there. I'm on the Facebook and, you know, the social media and all that. It's all on DukeOfTheBump.com. So yeah, bye, everyone.